All right, let's dive in to Workers AI. Today, we're going to explore how to make use of Cloudflare's AI model catalog using a Python notebook. My hope is to get you dreaming about all the new apps that you can build after this video. Hi, I'm Craig, and I'm a developer. Workers AI makes inference extremely straightforward. You might ask, what is inference? AI is all about input. You put something in, some processing happens, and it produces output. This is called inference, and Cloudflare makes that straightforward for you. Now, in case you didn't know this already, there are many, and I mean a ton of different AI models available for you to use. This here is one of our partner sites, Hugging Face. They provide their users with a growing list of open models to download. Now, each of these models were created for different reasons and typically built for a very specific use case. Since there are so many models, we often need to arrange them, and they get grouped by use cases, or often as we refer to them, tasks. A task is that magic processing bit. Now, if you were to find a model that matches exactly what you need, you could download it. But if you wanted to let others use it, you'd have to figure out some way to host it, like where your users could access it. And like in the case of a web app, you'd need your users to be able to access the model no matter where they are, no matter how many users you end up having too. This turns out to be quite challenging. The infrastructure required to run these models properly at scale proves to be incredibly difficult to manage, especially if you go it on your own. But don't worry, you aren't doing this alone. That's where we come in. We've already deployed a bunch of these models for you on our globally distributed network. We have them grouped by task, and there is, as you're about to see, an API that allows you to, in one single line of code, run inference at scale. All you need is a free API key. All right, so let's get cooking. This is the Jupyter Notebook where we're going to be hanging out. If you haven't used one of these before, they're pretty great for exploring software and taking notes. It maintains state and it lets you run blocks of code. So I've made this notebook available to you and you can download it or even click a link to run it directly in your browser. You don't even need to install anything to start exploring. Check out the notes attached to this video for links. We have a Python SDK, so we're going to make use of it for this exploration. However, our API is REST-based, so any language that can make HTTP requests can play along. So I'm going to click into this first cell here, and I'm going to install the packages that are required by pressing this play button up here. And then next, I'm going to run the imports, and you'll see there that I import Cloudflare from Cloudflare. So now we're into this configuration bit. These two values are all you need to get running. Now, obviously, I'm already signed up, but if you haven't yet, go ahead and sign up. It's free, like seriously, no credit card needed. And there's a super generous free tier, which is all we need to complete this video. It's cool. You can pause me. I'll wait. Now, after you get signed up, head over to your dashboard. Heads up, this part is going to probably look different. We're always trying to make things better for you. So if you head down to the AI section and then the Workers AI, in here, I want you to click this Use REST API. Now, if this is your first time here, there might be a bigger call out than this, but this is what you're looking for, this Use REST API, because that's what we're going to use up in this video. All right, so we're gonna go in here, I'm gonna choose Create a Workers AI API Token. I'm gonna name it whatever I want, I'll say Exploring, and then I'm gonna choose Create API Token. Boom, now I've got this. And now here's my key. And as best practices go, we only let you see this once. So I'm gonna copy this token and put it in a safe place. I'm going to pop mine into a file on my local machine in the same directory where I have this notebook. And I'm going to call the file .env for environment. And while we're here, I might as well grab my account ID. So I'm gonna click copy from here. And we're gonna need both the account ID and the API call. So I'm gonna put both of those in that file. Okay, so back to our notebook. Here is where we let the notebook know who we are. Now, I'm running that .env locally, which you can do as well. There's some instructions here on how to do that. But if you don't want to do that, if you want to just do that, you can go ahead and run these files here. So run this one here, and you'll see that it pulled from my environment file. But if not, it would prompt. That's totally fine. And so I'm going to run both of those. And now that we have both of those values, we can create a new client to call the API. And we initialize that with that API token. And now we're set. Let's get ready for the juicy part. I've broken this notebook into different task types. Our first one here is very popular these days, text generation. Text generation is used to power chatbots, generate personalized emails, create marketing plans, write code, and so much more. Text generation models are often adored because they seem to have access to infinite information. These are often referred to as large language models, or LLMs. They were trained on lots and lots of data. All right, in this example here, I am passing a model, the first parameter here. So the first parameter to workers.ai.run, I'm passing this model name. And I'm using an open model from Meta called Llama 3. Do you see how it's got the LLM in the word? It's pretty cute, right? So then I pass in my account ID. And then I have this messages array. Now, each of these messages have two properties for role and content. We provide a standard interface for all text generation models, meaning they all have these same parameters. So you can very easily swap the model out. The system message helps guide your experience, and you can explain the behavior that you expect as well as how you want your application to behave. These are pretty wild if you haven't played with them before. Then we have the user message, which is where you put like the input from the user. Let's jump into an example. This little application that I have here, if we can call it that, I built to be a productivity assistant for Jupyter Notebook users, and I asked it to respond in Markdown. Now, imagine that this is a chatbot and the user enters, how do I use keyboard shortcuts to execute cells? So let's run this and see what we get. Wow, look at this. So it tells me to press Command Enter on a Mac to execute a cell. It just knew that. And also, look, it was able to write in Markdown. I still find this pretty impressive, like every single time I run inference. I've included links to the documentation to our model catalog in each one of these sections. So here's this Explore Text Generation Models. I've got some of the best news that you're gonna hear all day. When models are labeled beta, the inference is completely free. I wanna yell that from the rooftops. You'll see here that there's also these models that are marked LoRA. That's low rank adaptation. And that means that you can fine tune these models with your own training data. You can read more about this in our docs. Also, I wanted to let you know that some of our models provide the ability to do function calling. You'll be able to give the LLM the ability to request information or perform actions from external services, which gives your text generation-based apps additional superpowers. Text to image. Text to image allows you to generate an image from a prompt. Some use cases for this are stock photos, creating video game characters, avatars, backgrounds, or designed logos. In this case, I'm going to use the DreamShaper model, which is a Stable Diffusion fine-tune that helps create realistic-looking photos. And I'm gonna ask it to create a software developer incredibly excited about AI and has a huge smile. And I'm gonna use Command Enter, like we just learned from that previous section there. Whoa, look at that. So if we take a look, you'll see that we offer several Stable Diffusion models. There's an in-painting model that allows you to provide a mask and replace certain parts of an existing image. The image-to-image style models allow you to create a new image based on an existing image. The next task I want to show off is the reverse of text-to-image. Image-to-text. Image-to-text allows you to ask questions about an image. The use cases here are automatic product descriptions for e-commerce, alt tag generation, and they do a surprisingly good job at OCR, which is optical character recognition, meaning it can read a photo. In this example, I'm going to be using the lava model. I'm going to pass it a photo of the Wall of Entropy, a wall of lava lamps that generate random numbers at the Cloudflare San Francisco office. Beautiful, right? And I'm just going to ask it to describe this photo. This image features a display of colorful glowing lava lamps. There are numerous lava lamps of various size and colors arranged in a visually appealing manner. I agree. It's pretty amazing, right? All right, so that's our vision APIs. automatic speech recognition. You can transcribe the audio from files. This is used for like customer service calls, maybe podcast transcriptions or subtitle generation. And it's so fast, you can even do live transcriptions. Now in this example, I'm using Whisper, right? So I'm using Whisper and all I need to do is pass in the audio. And I've made a little thing that we're gonna play here. You can hear me talking.
Well, hello there. I'm making a recording for a Jupyter notebook. That's a Python.
And then I spell it out.
J-U-P-Y-T-E-R.
I just want to say that it says it got Kubernetes, anyways, which is really impressive because that's hard to say.
Maybe make a little bit of noise. Say some hard words. I'm going to say Kubernetes. I'm not actually even talking about.
It's really, really good. And having text is powerful. Text embedding models allow you to take existing text and create semantic embeddings. Now, I'm going to head over to the docs here because this one's a little hard to demo. So once you create these embeddings, you can put them into a vector database. We already have one. It's called Vectorize. And this is what it looks like. So I put in some text and you can see what comes back are these strings. These are these entries here. So once you create these embeddings, you can put them into a vector database. Now, vector databases let you group these entries by similarity. So it's a great use case for things like recommendation systems. The most popular use case for embeddings these days is called retrieval augmented generation, or RAG for short. This allows you to include your own data in your LLM-based applications. So let's assume that you're building a new product. The LLM most likely won't contain any information at all about your product. Adding your own data is a very common need, so I think it's probably worth chatting about here, just in case you too are thinking about this. But what you could do would be to create multiple embeddings for each of your support docs, and then allow your users to interact with a very wise chatbot who could search semantically through all of your docs, find the most relevant entries, and provide them as context to the LLM when it responds. And then the LLM would know about your product. Okay, I'm gonna go through these last few here quickly, but reminder, you can and absolutely should play with these on your own. But let's rip through some more tasks real quick. These are handy to know that they exist. We have translations, super powerful. Imagine chaining the output from a model and piping into this model as input. Bastante impresionante indeed. Some use cases for this are like travel apps. You could build an e-learning app. Next up, we have text classification. The use case here is great for sentiment analysis, like something on social media comments. You should leave one, by the way. Along the same lines, we have image classification. This task provides some guesses as well as likelihood scores. This is a great for image apps where you want to do some sort of filtering and tagging. This one, totally sees a burrito that is the same size as my head. It is very certain that's a burrito. It's a large burrito. And the last one I'm going to share here is summarization. This is super powerful in generating TLDR, or too long, didn't read summaries. Again, imagine piping a transcript from a podcast into here and getting that blurb. We also have an entirely serverless dev environment, including functions, database, key-value stores, caching, and so much more. And believe it or not, it makes AI inference even easier than what we just did together. Literally everything you need to build a full stack AI application deployed to region Earth. But that's another video. Thanks so much for hanging out, and we'll see you real soon.